I started by creating this URL for the New York Times. Inside the URL, I append the city string that we created earlier, and I also make sure that I've got my API key at the end of it, which is obviously not XXXXXXXXXXXXXXX, probably a couple more X's. Anyways, moving on, so we pass into $.getJSON the URL that we just created here, and then an anonymous function. This anonymous function will get run as soon as we get the response back from the New York Times. I start off by setting the text of the header element to New York Times articles about, insert city here, and then I iterate through this data object, which is the actual response. Let's take a look at that. Inside the network tab in DevTools, I've gone ahead and looked at all of the requests sent out, and we see article search, so let's click on that. Looking at the preview tab, we can get a good idea of what our object looks like. Let's open up response, which is the highest level property within the JSON that's returned. We see that it contains docs and meta, and docs looks like an array. Let's open that up. And check this out, we have each of the articles that got returned. Let's open up the first. The first one has the URL under the property web URL, and we've got the headline right here. The headline has a property of main, and then we can see a string of the headline of this article. So inside our code, we're going to go ahead and create this articles object, which is from the data response, and then that high level response property and the docs inside of it. Scrolling down, we also find this snippet, which is a string of a snippet, or the first part of the article. Within each article, we're looking for web URL to use for the A tag, and we're also looking for a snippet to put inside the P tag. This is a pretty simple for loop. We'll just go through all the articles that get returned, and then append each one in turn. And now we've got all the articles showing up on the page. That's pretty cool. Let me show you one more trick. So if you're curious what will come from this URL before you run through this whole thing, you can actually just go ahead and paste this into your browser to see the result. I've gone ahead and pasted it in up here, and I'll press enter, and we get this massive string back. But look, this massive string is just a JSON. It's the exact same JSON we were looking at. This is a quick and easy way of seeing what will return from your AJAX requests without actually putting one into your app.